Hello friends, welcome to Tech StudyCell. In this video, we'll make a very useful home automation project using the Tasmota and ESP32 to control 8 appliances with Alexa and also from the manual switches. To make this project, I have just used ESP32 relay module and DHT11 sensor, and you don't need any coding knowledge. Anyone can make this project within 5 minutes. And I have not used any third-party app to make this project, and I will share the complete circuit diagram and all other details. But before going to that, let me show you how this project works. Alexa, turn on outdoor light.
Okay.
You can see the lamp turns on. Now I can also control it from the Amazon Alexa app. Now let me control it from the manual switch, and you can see the real-time status in the Amazon Alexa app. Let me turn it on and you can see the status updated. So in a similar way, I can control all the lamps from the manual switch and also from the Amazon Alexa app. Let me turn off all the lamps. You can see all lamps is turning off one by one. And you can also control these lamps from this Tasmota dashboard. So you can also monitor the real-time temperature and humidity from the DHT11 sensor. Now let me control it from the Tasmota dashboard, and you can see I can easily turn on and off the lamps. Now let me turn off the lamps from the manual switch, and again you can monitor the real-time feedback in the Tasmota dashboard. Now let me turn off the Wi-Fi and show you how this project works without internet. After turning off the Wi-Fi, I can only control these lamps from the manual switch, and there is no specific on and off position. Whenever you press the switch, the current state of the lamp will be changed. So you can see I can easily control the lamps without internet, and you can also use push button for that. Now let me turn on the Wi-Fi again. After turning on the Wi-Fi, the ESP32 will automatically connect with the internet. Then again, we can control the appliances with Alexa. Alexa, turn off all the lamps. And you can control these appliances from different Wi-Fi network with Amazon Alexa app. Only the ESP32 and Echo Dot should be connected with the same Wi-Fi network. So this is a very useful home automation project, and I will really appreciate if you support us on Patreon. I will share all the link in the video description. Now without any further delay, let's get started. To make this project, you need a ESP32, a 8-channel relay module. You can use your existing switchboard, or you can also use push button to control the appliances manually. And this is optional. If you want, you can use this DHT11 sensor. And to control the appliance with Alexa, you need a Echo Dot or any other Alexa device. Now we have to connect all these components as per this circuit diagram. In the circuit, you can see I have given the 5V supply to ESP32, DHT11 sensor and the relay module. And these push buttons are connected across the GPIO pin and the ground pin. Now if you use switch, then you can refer this circuit. You just have to connect the switches across the GPIO pin and the ground pin as per this circuit. And to connect the appliances with the relay module, you can refer this circuit. ESP32 GPIOs will be connected with this control pin, and these are the AC appliances connected with the relay module. Now if you want to use 4th channel relay module, then you can refer this circuit to connect 4th channel relay module with ESP32. As you can see, there are a lot of connections, so to make the circuit compact, I will use this PCB for the project, but you can use the ESP32 and the relay module to make this complete project. Now let me connect the ESP32 with the PCB. Then I will connect this DHT11 sensor. Now we can connect these external switches with the PCB using this pin. So you can directly connect this switch or any other external switch with this pin. But here I will control this relay from this push button. But as I said, you can use both push button or switch to control the relay module as per your requirement. Now I will connect the ESP32 with the laptop to flash it with Tasmota firmware. For that, first you have to visit this article. I will share the link in the video description. Then click on these two buttons to download the Tasmota firmware and the flashing tool. So for this project, I will use this Tasmota32.bin file. So let me click on this link to download the file. And I will use this ESP Flasher tool to flash the ESP32. So you can download the tool as per the system you are using. Here I am using Windows 64-bit system, so I will click here to download the ESP Flasher. After that, let me go to the download folder, and here you can see you need just these two files to flash the ESP32. Now let me open the ESP Flasher tool, and we have already connected the ESP32 with the laptop. So let me select the COM port. Then click on browse and select the Tasmota32.bin file which you have just downloaded. Then click on open. After that, click on this flash ESP button. Now we have to press and hold the boot button of ESP32. Now you can see the flashing process started. It may take some time. After the flashing completes, you will find a hotspot name and a IP. So now we have to connect with this hotspot and enter this IP to update the Wi-Fi credential. So let me click here, and here you can see I have to select this hotspot and click on connect. So it will redirect to this page where you can update the Wi-Fi credential. But if you face any issue, then just copy this IP, then go to browser and paste the IP here and press the enter. So again, you can access this page, then enter the Wi-Fi name and the password. After that, click on save. We have to copy this IP, then again connect with the Wi-Fi, then paste the IP in the browser. And here you can see this is the Tasmota dashboard where we will do all the configuration. First, I will click on this configuration button, then click on configure module. So here you can see we can configure all the GPIO of ESP32 from this window. So let me open the notepad file, and here you can see these are the GPIO pin connected with the relays, and these are the GPIO pin connected with the switch or push button. So first I will configure all the GPIO connected with the relays. So again, let me go to the browser. So here relay 1 is connected with the GPIO 23. So here I will select relay_i, as I am using active low relay module. If you use active high relay module, then just select the relay here. So let me select the relay_i, as I am using active low relay module. And here I will select 1, as this is the first relay. Now relay 2 connected with the GPIO 22. So here I will again select relay_i, and this is the second relay. So here I have to select the 2. So in a similar way, you have to configure all the GPIO pins connected with the 8 relays. So here you can see we have configured all the GPIO pin connected with the relay. So again, I will go to notepad. Now I will configure all the GPIO pins connected with these switches. So as per the circuit, GPIO 13 is connected with the switch 1. So if you use switch, then you have to select switch here. But as I said, here I am using buttons. So let me select the button, and this GPIO connected with the first button or switch. So here one is selected. Now the GPIO 12 connected with the switch 2. So again, here I will select button, and here I have to select 2. And as I said, if you use switch, then select the switch at this place. So in a similar way, I have to configure all the GPIO pins connected with the buttons. After that, I have to configure the GPIO 16 where DHT11 sensor is connected. If you want to use any other sensor, then you have to select that sensor from this drop down. So let me select the DHT11. Now after doing all this configuration, you have to click on this save button, then click on main menu. So in the Tasmota dashboard, you can now monitor the temperature from DHT11 sensor. Please ignore the ESP32 temperature. This is not accurate. And here you will find the 8 buttons to control the relays from this dashboard. So let me press this button to turn on the relays. So here you can see if I press the button, the respective relay turns on. Now let me turn off all the relay from the push button, and you can monitor the real-time feedback in the Tasmota dashboard. Thus, you can easily control the relay module from this dashboard. Now let me connect the Amazon Alexa with Tasmota to control the device with Alexa. For that, again I have to click on this configuration button. Now I have to click on configure other. Here we have to enter the friendly name for all the device. Let me enter smart home here. This is the project name. Then let me enter the friendly name for the first device. So Alexa will identify the first device with this name. So whenever you say Alexa turn on study lamp, it will turn on the first device. So in a similar way, you have to enter the friendly name for all the device. You can give any name as per your requirement. After that, you have to select the Hue Bridge multi device, then click on save, then go to main menu. Now let me quickly configure the Amazon Alexa app to add all the Tasmota devices. So first I will open the Amazon Alexa app, then go to device, then tap on this plus icon and select add device, then tap on the light, then select other. Now tap on the discover devices. During this time, the ESP32, Echo Dot and the smartphone should be connected with the same Wi-Fi network. You can see Alexa found 8 devices. Now I will go to device, and in the light we can see all the devices we have connected. Now let me control it from the Amazon Alexa app, and you can see I can easily control it with the Amazon Alexa app. Now let me connect this smartphone with the different network. Let me turn off the Wi-Fi and turn on the mobile data, and you can see still I can control the relays from this Amazon Alexa app. So the Echo Dot and the ESP32 should be connected with the same Wi-Fi network. Then you can control this device from Amazon Alexa app from anywhere in the world. Now I will connect the 8 lamps with the relay module as per this circuit diagram. As you can see, I have connected these lamps with the relay module as per the circuit. Alexa, turn on outdoor light.
Okay.
Alexa, turn on studio light.
Okay.
So I can easily control it with Alexa. Now let me control these lamps from the push button. And again, I can easily control all these lamps. So this is a very useful home automation project you can make without writing a single line code. And you can also join our Telegram channel Tech StudyCell for more such home automation ideas. I will share the link in the video description. Now if you find this video helpful, then please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.